big time, Mary Beth. It's a fast lane.
You two ever get tired of life at the 14th, I'd be glad to have you in narcotics.
Go to bed with me, both of you.
What is this?
I'm sure you didn't say anything that would taint the collar. You're too smart for that.
If you go into the grand jury on Tuesday and call me a liar, our partnership's over.
Are you that good, Sergeant?
Okay, I have the type of the report. You want to tell me what lie I'm... Morning, sir.
Morning.
I'm swearing, too. That's what we thought when we took over the place. Personally, I think we'd have been better off with the Medicare crowd.
Yeah. I guess the only drugs your people are interested in are the recreational kind.
You are not joking. They walk in here, bold as can be. Can you sell me a dozen ludes?
Can you?
I beg your pardon?
You got a supplier?
No, thank you. We're not interested.
Speak for yourself, Patricia.
Daphne?
I am the one who's got a kid on the way I'm going to have to pay for on my own.
So sit and hearing about this baby.
We can have this fight on our own time, thank you. Supplier?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of drugs are we talking about?
How about the prescription kind without regulations or paperwork? I've got amphetamines, phenobarbital, everything in between.
I don't know.
Patricia, who is the one that's always whining about the low profit margin? Huh? The least we could do is listen to the woman. Huh?
How do you do this? No risk to you. All of the pills have been accounted for, so no one's gonna come looking for them.
Uh-huh. It's foreign stuff, right? You smuggle back in? Right?
Look, you don't need to know that.
No. I don't need to know that.
And it wouldn't be real smart of me to discuss the small strokes with you. You gonna find that necessary for us to do business, Patricia?
I could live without it.
No,
I'm okay.
Good. Then you just tell me what you need. I give you a price. You give me cash, and I can have you supplied the same day.
The way you worked her was terrific. You set her up so nicely with that struggling businesswoman routine, that stuff about the baby, and you let her make all the moves. Absolutely perfect. In fact, I'll probably use this tape as a training film. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Petrie, Miss Becky, nice job on backup. A good solid caller.
It was tough turning on the camera, but somebody had to do it.
You two ever get tired of life at the 14th, I'd be glad to have you in narcotics. Score one for the good guys.
Thank you, sir. Yes, thank you.
Yeah, they're really good. Great job.
Hey! All right, that's it. No. Don't get up, sit down, continue with your work. We're all adults here. What, going so soon? Hi. Well, how good am I?
Real good, Cagney. Real good.
What'd you expect?
A little modesty, Sergeant?
I am very modest, Petrie, on those rare occasions when I have something to be modest about.
Hey, Josie.
You've done good, Cagney.
Thank you, Josie. Good eye. Thank you all. Why is the applause
stopping?
Congratulations.
Thank you for gracing this humble squad room with your incredible presence.
You're welcome, welcome, welcome. I would like to take this opportunity to speak for me, myself, personally, and my partner, Detective Mary Beth Lacey. We want you all to know that we will never forget the little people who knew us when we started out. You may all applaud again. Thank you so much. So where's Rather?
Rather who?
Dan Rather.
You're not well, Christine.
Mary Beth, we are newsworthy. At least Connie Chung.
Good call, you two.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
They're saying good things about you upstairs.
Oh, yeah? Like what? By whom?
Easy, easy, Cagney. You know, 3 days minus four bodies made a pretty wild place around here. So I need sober heads tomorrow, you hear? Not too much celebrating tonight, huh?
Yes.
Congratulations, Lacey.
Thank you.
Good job.
Messages. Not too precarious, nothing terrific.
What do you know?
Harvey. Harvey's obstetrician. How about your checkup? Everything moving along okay?
Everything. Thank you so much.
Yeah, yes, Becky, you must be slipping. And nothing for you, Petrie. I guess Claudia's out studying motel architecture with a night school teacher or something. Hey, somebody said it was just a joke. Well, he's so sensitive.
Wish I could say the same for you, Sergeant.
Hey,
get out of my way!
Hey, Marcus, don't be mad at me!
Jeez. It's the system that allows you guys to do these kind of things. You play on people's greed to get them to commit a crime.
Yeah? I didn't hear you object when Paul Newman and Robert Redford did the same thing in The Sting.
You get inside their heads. You set them up on the right day at the right time. Gestapo tactics.
Oh, Harv, you're way off base here. She offered. We didn't ask. She offered to sell us drugs. She had a choice.
No, babe. She was headed for prison the day she made the list.
List? What list?
Government wants you, they'll get you. Daniel Ellsberg, Gene Seberg, DeLorean. It is all the same.
Harvey, I don't think that we can have this conversation.
What about those senators a few years back, huh? Abscam? What chance do they have? A guy comes up to you,
all right,
he says...
All right, Harv, listen, I take your point, okay? So let's drop it.
All I am saying is the government has the power to destroy anybody they want. By the way, we're not arguing here.
Okay. You think that the government and the people I work with are out to get innocent citizens, and I do not. But we're not arguing.
Of course not.
Okay. Let's go to sleep.
Good night. Started with J. Edgar Hoover.
Oh.
Turned this country into a police
state. Oh, my Lord.
You did.
They're looking all over you. Get away from me. Hey, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
So what? You're sorry. I tell you something very private, and the next thing I know, I'm hearing it back from the biggest mouth in the squad.
Look, Coleman asked me
what was wrong with you lately. Look, all I said was that Claude, you're spending a lot of time in night school. That's it. That's all I said.
Even if I believed you, that's enough. You shouldn't have even said that.
It was a lucky guess, I swear it.
I can't believe I let you do this to me. Victor, you're stupid. An idiot. But I'm a bigger idiot to think that you were my friend or that I could talk to you.
Hey.
Get off me! I don't like my life aired in that squad room.
If you'd have just laughed, no one would have known it was the truth. Everybody would have just thought you were laughing at one of Coleman's bad jokes.
Of course, it's my fault. You're unbelievable.
It's not what I mean. Marcus, I know I blew it. I didn't mean to, but I did, and I'm really sorry. You know, I felt really special that you even told me. Marcus, we're friends. It's water under the bridge. It won't happen again. I give you my word on it.
I don't need your word, Victor. Because I'm putting in for a new partner tomorrow. So don't worry about it. See you, George.
Good night.
Narcotics has got your back. They turned your saleswoman around. She's going to give us a higher level dealer, and Nelman has approved it. Johnson is expecting at One Police Plaza in half hour.
I'd like to be replaced.
Why?
It's personal.
I don't want to hear personal. It ticks me off that I'm going to be shorthanded here again, and there's nothing I can do about it. How the hell do you expect me to run a precinct like this? Go!
The guy shows it to me, says, how do you like the yacht? That's not a yacht, I said. That's a canoe. I mean, I want to sleep six all the way to Bimini. Try the veal here. You'll love it.
No, nothing for me, thanks. Say, this is the best Italian food in the city. Oh, somehow eating with cops spoils my appetite. Have a nice day, gents.
What do you mean, cops? Oh, come here. Come back here, will you?
What are you talking?
Mistakes.
Overkill on the money talk? Rich dealers don't have to strut it.
No, I think it was a nice setup. Mansfield doesn't deal with street soldiers.
They look like cops.
Maybe. Petrie, what do you think?
I didn't see any mistakes.
Bingo. Mansfield, he's shrewd. We've tried to sting him three times now, and every time he smelled trouble. He's very good at playing games. He'll even try to force you to entrap him.
Does he ever serve time, sir?
Not even an indictment. From pot to smack and everything in between. Maybe he's backed by the mob. Maybe he bankrolled the Benedetti murder. I don't know. He's crud, and I would love to get him. And this time, I think we've got a shot. He trusts Laura Farrell. You two are as good as I've seen, and not exactly typical-looking narcs. Lacey, the stomach, absolutely beautiful.
Thank you, sir.
Just remember, he's got to make the first move.
What are we buying?
Just pills, large quantity. This time, you'll be mini moguls from out of town. The Premier Towers. Petrie, Miss Becky, the camera and I will be here in room 907. The sting will be in 909. The camera will see through this two-way mirror in the center of the room. Now, we're using a wide-angle lens, but you still got to try to keep the action here in this area. If you get into the bathroom, the dressing area, or at the door, you're out of frame. So try to keep it tight. Questions? Okay, folks. Showtime.
He's smart, Mary Beth. He's sophisticated. We can't seem too easy. He's not going to buy it. He's sharp. We just got to be sharper.
We will be.
It's the big time, Mary Beth. It's the fast lane.
Uh-huh.
You got to know these kind of people. I can handle them.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead.
They're on the way up.
All right.
Yeah.
They're on the elevator.
On their way.
Mary Beth, Christine, Bruce.
Hello.
How do you do?
It's nice to meet you.
And Don.
Thanks for stopping by.
It's my pleasure. I don't like it. It doesn't feel right.
What?
I'm not doing business today. Sorry.
Well, wait a minute. What's the problem?
You can be cops.
The room could be bugged.
I follow my instincts. My instincts tell me no.
Wait a minute, how do we know you're not a cop? How do we know Laura here isn't an informant?
Yeah, how does one know?
The eyes. I check the eyes. A cop's eyes never rest.
Like yours?
Like yours?
There's a fine line between cops and robbers.
Right. Which side are you on?
Go to bed with me, both of you.
What is this?
Have sex with me before we do business. Then I'll know you're not cops.
I'm pregnant, mister.
Well, that leaves just you and me, kiddo.
How does having sex with us make you safe?
Precedent. U.S. versus Simpson. It's out in California. They entrapped Mr. Simpson by engaging him in sex. It's called outrageous conduct. Oh, no. No, thank you. Not today.
Wait. Bruce? Where are you going? I thought we were going to have a good time.
Okay, my place. If you want to reach me, Laura knows how to get in touch.
Bruce? Look, everybody's tense. We've been dry for a long time now. I don't even have anything for myself. And we got a score. So if I can't go home with at least some moods, we're gonna be out of business. That's what it takes.
You're saying that if I solve your supply problem, you and I can have a good time?
Yeah, I'd like that.
What exactly do you need?
Ups, moods, a couple of thousand more if you got it. Well, my list is inside. Can we do business?
After you.
Get him.
Yeah, let me see your list. I'm sure I can give you everything you need.
Oh, yeah, I can go 5K on the loots and the ups.
All units, stand by.
I'm low on tranks.
When can you make delivery?
Well, if you've got the cash, I can have it for you in 15 minutes.
I got the cash.
Come on, let's move it.
This could get him into major cases easy. For a chance like that, I'd even put on a dress. And you'd probably look sensational in a pair of high heels. You remember Michelle the Magnificent? Sure you do. I talk about her all the time. To tell you the truth, the first night, didn't happen. I couldn't,
What is this, Victor? I don't want to hear this story.
No, I want to tell you this. Never happened to me before. She tried to be nice about it. That made things even worse. Anyway, you can tell Cagney or Coleman or send out a newsletter if you want. I don't care. I told you the story.
I know why you tell the story. Because you thought it would make us even. You embarrass me, I embarrass you. Fair is fair?
Right.
Wrong. Victor, what's the use? We have different values. Interests, everything. It's a bad match, always has been.
I think you're blowing this out of proportion, Marcus.
I don't think so.
It's been 10 minutes. He's either talking or he isn't. Maybe he's trying to make up his mind. Find out what's taking so long.
Lacey. Have the amniocentesis test yet?
Hey, Sergeant, that's none of your business.
Yeah, just trying to be helpful.
Sergeant Coleman, I'm going to tell you something for the last time. You keep your fat nose out of my personal life.
Hey, hang on a minute here.
No, I hate that Guanella thing in there. I told you that 100 times. And now you have the nerve to ask me if I'm going to get a test so you can get the edge on whether it's a boy or girl? Forget it. If I have the test, that's between me, my husband, and my doctor. And if I do, I'm telling the lab I don't want to know the sex. And no matter what I do, I would never, never help you make money off of my baby.
You finished?
Yes, sir.
Well, let me tell you something here. You think I brought this up just to make a few bucks?
Why else are you bothering me?
Because when my wife and I were expecting a baby, she didn't have the test. Then when Betty was born... Well, she's in a special school now. It took us a long time to find it. And she's happier there. People don't make fun of her. She's doing okay. It's just that when she was born, we weren't prepared, is all.
Betty's a pretty name. That's short for Elizabeth, right? We were thinking about Elizabeth, if it's a girl. Or Muriel, maybe, which is after Harv's mother.
It's a nice idea.
I just told your partner here the man is mute until his lawyer shows.
Parker Simonson.
One of the best. But we've got a good sting on tape, plus we've got a suitcase full of pills. We'll have to account for the time in the hallway, of course, but I'm sure you didn't say anything that would taint the collar. You're too smart for that.
Lieutenant, what I said in the hallway...
Cagney, you don't have to tell me what you said, not right now. Take the weekend. Think about it. Go over it between yourselves. Bring me a report on Monday. We'll get this into the grand jury by Tuesday at the latest. We made a great collar today. So whatever it takes, let's not lose it.
Fine. Thank you, Lieutenant.
Ladies.
Sergeant, we're doing the test next week.
Yeah.
I can't believe I stepped over the line like that. When I stopped him outside, I could have said something else, anything. I didn't have to initiate the deal. We're gonna have to come up with something creative on our report.
What are you talking about?
I entrapped him, Mary Beth. I was the first one to bring up the subject of drugs. We put that on the report. Mansfield walks. I'm not about to let that happen.
Well, what are we supposed to do, lie?
It's our word against his. We're not dealing drugs.
Good. Come on, sometimes you gotta do whatever it takes. You know that. I'll be damned if a big-time drug dealer's gonna walk because I didn't say the magic words. You heard Lieutenant Johnson. He practically ordered us to lie if we had to.
Yeah, well, he's not gonna be under oath. I can't believe he even asked us to do that. He's supposed to be our superior officer.
He's just trying to give us a little room.
Yeah, room to hang ourselves.
He's backing us up.
He's telling us to commit a crime.
Oh, please. Will you come down to earth with the rest of us? How often do you get a shot at a guy like Mansfield?
Not worth it, Chris.
Wait a minute. Mary Beth, we're doing this.
Your ego is doing all the talking here.
Oh, give me a
break. Thinking about promotions and commendations and having your picture in police
magazine.
That
isn't true. It is not true. Mansfield stinks, and I want him.
I want him as much as you do. But we have to start all over again. We have to admit we made a mistake.
No! We're going to do this now, Mary Beth. Please don't fight me on this one, because you can't win.
You got a hell of a nerve, lady. I make my own decisions.
Monday, I'm bringing in the paper, and it's going to say all the right words. Now, you can either corroborate my testimony, or you can say you never heard the conversation at all. I really don't care. But if you go into the grand jury on Tuesday and call me a liar, our partnership's over.
Blackmail, and I don't like it.
I don't like it either.
Does it all the time. Puts you in danger while she does a super cop number.
That's fair, Mom.
Fair
with eight. All right, your turn, kid.
You
look out for him, Harvey.
You know, you guys lie in that courtroom and get caught, the judge is going to come down on you like a ton of bricks.
Not a chance, Harvey. Only three people know what was said in that hallway, and two of us are officers of the law.
Hey, Mom! What?
I'm watching you, sweetheart. Go ahead. That's all right. Don't worry about it. Go again.
Yeah, maybe you should call a bluff. You might be better off with another partner.
I don't want to think about that, Harvey. Anyway, she didn't mean it. Maybe she did mean it. I call her a liar in front of the grand jury. That's it. It's all over. I'm not trying to be self-righteous here, Harvey. You know, I...
Why?
I don't know, but... One more dealer off the street. Lord knows it couldn't hurt.
Oh, yeah? You commit perjury, Mary Beth. You go to prison.
Five is good. Good for you. Your turn, Papa.
Yeah, my turn.
What the hell does Lacey expect you to do? Let him walk? I mean, your job is to get the scum off the streets, whatever it takes.
He beat me, Charlie. He baited me, and it worked. I'm the one who blew it.
You didn't blow anything.
I knew I wouldn't get another chance.
You don't need another chance. You got him now. Oh, draws these things. It looks like a jigsaw puzzle.
Mary Beth has to do everything by the book. Otherwise, she doesn't sleep at night.
Well, then she's in the wrong job.
Well, fine.
Listen, Chris, I used to cut corners. Bend the rules. I also lied in court anytime it was necessary. We all did. I slept like a baby.
Well, things are different now, Charlie.
Oh, you can say that again. You guys aren't really cops. You're nothing but lawyers with badges.
Thank you.
The criminal justice system today stinks. I mean, even if you got a good, solid case, you don't know what's going to happen the minute you step foot in that courtroom. I'm glad I'm out of it. Don't worry about it anymore. But I'll tell you something. You better tell your partner she is not living in the real world. Give me that piece over there, will you?
Which one?
The one that fits. Which, give me them both.
Charlie, I don't know. Take them off.
She has integrity, Pop.
Integrity is also knowing when to sidestep the rules. And if Mary Beth is a decent partner, she'll go to the wall with you. No questions asked. Hooray, it fits.
Good. You want a soda?
No, I don't want a soda. When I finish this bookshelf, I want a drink. I think you could use one, too.
Away from me. We need to talk.
We've already talked. It happened. And it's over.
But you're still punishing me.
That's not true.
The hell it isn't. I'm sorry I hurt you. I've asked for your forgiveness. What more can I do?
I don't know, Claudia. You're the one who cheated.
Oh, excuse me. I forgot I was talking to Mr. Wonderful. The guy who never makes a mistake. The perfect cop. The knight in shining armor.
Claudia, shut up!
Why do I have to push you to a wall before I get your attention? Marcus, if we can't get past this, we don't have a future. With Arts and Leisure. You still have the home living section. What about sports?
I'm sorry, sweetheart.
I meant to turn it off. Go back to sleep. Put the snooze alarm on. You still got 9 minutes.
What you gonna do, babe?
I don't know yet.
Mary Beth, would you sign me in, please? Thanks. You're wrong to put our partnership on the line over this. I expect you to back me up, Murray, but
you're not willing to do it. We don't have a partnership.
A partnership is 50-50.
Right.
You owe me my share of any decision. Instead, you throw your little ultimatum in my face, and I don't like it.
All right, then I'm sorry about that, but this is not a negotiable issue for me.
Why not? Because you're afraid to admit a mistake?
No! No, please. Please, you've got to believe me. I want Mansfield, Mary Beth. I don't want Mansfield and his two hotshot rich attorneys get in a chauffeur-driven limousine and they drive off thumbing their noses at us. It makes me sick, Mary Beth.
Yes, sir.
I have a chance to get in, and I'm not going to walk away.
The one that was appointed will...
I'm sorry about the ultimatum. I'm a pushy broad.
True.
Look, if you want to say you never heard the conversation between Mansfield and me in the hallway, I'll understand.
But I did. No, I'm going to do it, God help me. Okay, I have to type up the damn report. You want to tell me what lie I'm... Morning, sir.
Morning.
I'm swearing, too.
Petrie, it's Becky. Come on in. What's this all about?
Did you read it? Self-explanatory.
Yeah, of course I read it. But I'm not going to give you a new partner without some good reasons. Did you know about this?
Yeah.
Well? Huh? Talk to me. Somebody, I'm listening.
It's my fault, Lieutenant. I betrayed his trust, and it wasn't the first time. To tell you the truth, I haven't been much of a partner at all. I'm always late with my paperwork. He usually has to clean up behind me on the street. The bottom line is, he's been holding me up for a long time now.
All right, Victor, don't go overboard. He's a good cop, and we've shared the load pretty evenly. The problem is that we're not compatible. I think we'd both be better off with new partners.
You got problems at home, Petrie?
What would make you think that, Lieutenant?
Because you've been walking around here eating up the furniture for about the past month now.
You're telling me you didn't hear about it?
What, I missed a juicy bit of gossip or something? Maybe I ought to come out of the office more often. Look, I'm not about to split up one of my best teams without a fight. Now, we all know that you can be extremely obnoxious from time to time and that you're too sensitive for your own good. So I'll tell you what we're gonna do. I want to hear everything. I want to hear every beef you got between yous right here and now. And if we can't find a way to mend fences before this is over, and we're not leaving here until it is, then I'll grant your request. All right, you go first, Miss Becky.
Lieutenant.
I'm not fooling around here.
I don't have a beef with him.
Gotta be something.
He's perfect. The guy is perfect.
And that bothers you?
Yeah. Yeah, it does bother me. You're always so perfect. And you don't mind letting me know that you know it. You don't say it, though, and that's what really irks me. You got an attitude, Petrie, a real attitude.
What the hell is wrong with trying to be perfect?
Sometimes you're not even human.
As defined by you, Victor? What do you know about human? You do all your thinking with your glands.
Okay, this is good.
And I'm tired of your rooster stories. You're never on time. You always complain. Victor, you talk too much, and I'm sick of it.
I told you I was sorry.
And that's supposed to solve everything.
What am I supposed to do?
Keep your sorry and get out of my face. Is that human enough for you, Victor?
This is very good.
Yeah, Petrie, you want to go at it? Let's go at it.
Come ahead now. I'm right here.
Lovely day for a hearing. You nervous? A little. I didn't sleep last night.
Are you expecting sympathy?
You're doing the right thing, Mary Beth. This one is worth it.
Yeah.
We don't do this now. Mansfield goes back out on the
street. Enough, okay? I'm gonna do it.
Mate, Mary Beth, thank you.
Good-looking suit, Christine.
Before I open the briefcase, I want to see the money.
We'll do it at the same time. I'll show you mine, you show me yours.
Ladies, that shade of green is my favorite color. Donald will want 5,000 ludes, 3,500 of the barbs. What is this?
Bruce, you should have trusted your instincts. You've just been immortalized on videotape.
Mr. Mansfield, you're under arrest.
Wow, that's incredible. It's incredible. You can stop it now, John. Incredible! I haven't seen anything that good on television since The Untouchables. Anybody like Elliot Ness? I loved Elliot Ness. Okay, Mr. Ackerman. Your side is going to tell us what happened in the hallway, is that right?
Yes, Your Honor. Sergeant Cagney spoke with Mr. Mansfield in the hallway and can tell us what transpired.
Well, by God, John, on your feet. Get over there and put the lady under oath. This is exciting.
Raise your right hand. Do you promise to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
You can sit down again, Sergeant. This is informal.
Thank you, Your Honor. After Mr. Mansfield walked out of the room, I decided to give it another try, as you saw on the videotape.
When I caught up with him in the hallway, I said to him, please wait. He turned and sort of smiled at me. Then he walked over towards me. And at that time, I said, I wish you wouldn't go. It was obvious he was playing games with me.
Objection, Your Honor. That is pure conjecture.
Oh, come on, Mr. Parker. This isn't a trial. Sit down, take a load off. You'll live longer. Go on, Sergeant.
Anyway, Mr. Mansfield said to me, you're pretty hyper, aren't you? I said, sometimes. He said, well, you need to relax. You need a lube, don't you? I've got lots of lubes. And I said, so I understand. He then smiled again. He said, I bet if I solve your supply problem, you and I could have a good time. And I said, I'd like that. At that time, he asked me what it was I needed. And I told him I needed a couple of thousand lewds and some ups. And then I pretended that I couldn't remember the rest. And I said that I'd left my shopping list inside. He then laughed and he said, what the hell? I know you're not cops. I just like to test people. We'll do business, then you and I can have some fun. At that point, we all went back into the room.
That's a nice story, Sergeant. Well told and concise. Now, you're telling us here that Mr. Mansfield initiated the actual drug deal, even though he had previously expressed an aversion to doing business with you. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
I see. Mm-hmm. Fine. Thank you, Sergeant.
Your Honor, my client has an entirely different version of that story.
I would hope so, Mr. Parker. I think a 30-minute recess would be pleasant right about now. When we come back, Mr. Mansfield will have a chance to enthrall us. Mr. Ackerman, I would like to see you and your group in my chambers. And Mr. Parker, you can come too. No offense, Mr. Ackerman, but you gotta walk a country mile to believe this lady's story. Even if I do, who's to say a jury will?
We've got a very strong case, Your Honor.
Predicated on the assumption that our bright young sergeant here didn't make the first move and entrap pretty boy. And from where I'm sitting, that's practically impossible to believe. Are you that good, Sergeant?
I don't know, Your Honor. I only knew that I couldn't be the first one to bring up the subject of drugs or deal-making. That would have tainted the collar.
Let me tell you something. Right now, you have the luxury of my ear. This could be considered a misinterpretation of facts. But if you go back into that hearing room and stick to this story, I expect Mr. Parker is going to land on you so hard you'll have to reach up to tie your shoe.
Harder.
And feeling the way I do right now, I'll probably help you.
With all due respect, Your Honor, sometimes truth is stranger than fiction.
Oh, I know.
We also have the corroborating testimony of Detective Lacey.
Ah, okay. You heard the exchange, Detective?
Yes, yes, sir.
And you heard Mansfield initiate the deal?
Yes, sir. He brought it up.
What exactly did he say?
He said exactly what my partner testified that he said, sir.
I want to hear you say it. But before you continue, do you realize the dire consequences if I find out you're bending the truth?
Yes, sir.
All right, little lady. Let's hear it.
Mr. Mansfield walked out of the room. And my partner and I looked at each other. And she went after him. And she said, I wish you would not leave. And then Mr. Mansfield said, you're pretty hyper, aren't you? And Sergeant Cagney said, sometimes. And Mr. Mansfield said, you need to relax. You need a lube, don't you? I have lots of lubes. Mm-hmm. And
Your Honor, I would like it if Detective Lacey would not continue with her story.
Talk to me, Blondie. It's now or never.
I initiated the deal, Your Honor. I pushed my partner into backing my story up. It is my fault.
You wear a badge, so you're above the law.
No, Your Honor.
Then what the hell did you think you were doing coming into my courtroom and lying? I know it makes you crazy sometimes. We expect you to rid the street of drug dealers, and then we handcuff you with a lot of stupid little word games, but that's the way it is. And if you can't stand the heat, get the hell out of the kitchen. I'm angry now, and I don't like to get angry. Life's too short. I don't know what to do with you two.
Other than give you a good sharp slap on the wrist, what I should do is send you back to history class to learn something about America.
I'll leave the rest of your punishment to the department.
I will grant Mr. Parker's motion to suppress, which means you don't have a case. Miss Lee's bag walks.
Look at this here. I was wrong about everything. Yeah. And I blew the collar. Sergeant Hotshot sure got her wings clipped, didn't she? Yeah. Lieutenant Johnson didn't exactly rush to our rescue. Did you expect him to? Well, yeah. I didn't expect an oral reprimand. Not from him. Chris, the man may have hinted at lying, but he didn't actually say it. He didn't entrap us. Mary Beth, what now? Huh? Where do we go from here? I don't know, partner. There is a dope dealer out there. He's about 6 feet tall, 250 pounds. He wears a pinky ring. He's a real virus. And it's not like we'd have to look too hard to find him. A little surveillance, maybe. Catch him with the goods, if you're game.
Hi, ladies. Take a pamphlet.
Thank you.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
You know, I've never even been to the Statue of Liberty. I've lived in this city most of my life. Oh, I can't wait till they get her all dialed up so Bob and I can take the boys back out there. They loved it the first time. Did you ever take that little boat around the island? That's good, too. Yeah? You should do it, Christine. Yeah, maybe I will.